Zo'n 25 jaar geleden werden in de VS diverse misbruikzaken gelinkt aan satanische rituelen. In Regression speelt Ethan Hawke een politieinspecteur die stuit op zo'n zaak.
You okay? Thank you, but
to protect you.
All right. Appreciate it.
My dad said you were a jerk. That you always complained when he fixed your car.
Sometimes I get pissed off when people don't do their job well. I mean, I'm not exactly what you might call a nice guy, you know?
Yes, you are. To me, at least. Good night.
Good night. And hey, thank you.
Regression is based on some true cases from the 80s and 90s. When did you come across these stories?
A few years back, and 6 years ago, I already wanted to make a movie about the devil, and a horror movie, but I was focused on it for a while, and I couldn't find a right approach that would make the story special. Then I abandoned the project, and by chance I read about this phenomenon, and I was amazed that I hadn't heard any of it, considering how big it was at its time.
How much of reality did you put in, and how much fiction? Like the detective, is he someone based on someone you...
No, it's that's invented. But it's different when you do a movie based on real events, as for instance, Mar Adentro, one of my movies was, where you really try to, although you always have to change things, it's impossible to be close to reality, but you try to keep the soul of that man, of the story. In this case, I wanted to reflect what the phenomenon was, so I read about many cases, but I didn't want this story to be particularly linked to a specific case.
Listen, the doctor just wants to inspect your mark. What's wrong? I mean, would you prefer if it was a female?
It's not that.
What is it? Tell me, what is it?
If I show it to you, they'll kill me.
You listen to me. Right now, it's incredibly important that you tell us everything. All right, we think that your grandmother... Come on, there were more people there with painted faces. Why won't you confirm it?
The devil's on their side.
Why did you want to make a film about the devil?
It was just an excuse to make a horror movie, because I'm a huge fan of horror as a genre, and my first movie was a horror, was about snuff movies, and I considered different possibilities. One was the devil or ghosts. I already had that one, or vampires or zombies, and I decided the devil. Some of the greatest horror movies that I enjoyed when I was a boy were from the 70s, like
Rosemary's
based
Baby.
On the devil, Rosemary's Baby, well, late 60s, and The Exorcist, The Omen. So it was just for the fun of it. And but the tricky thing was to find the proper approach. What happened was that once I started to tell the story about this phenomenon, it shifted the project from being a horror movie more procedural and a psychological thriller.
Why did you want to tell this story now?
Our society nowadays is not obsessed with the devil, as North America was in the 80s or 90s, but there is still ideas. Fear, and there are still ideas. Now, you can see in some circles just talking about the end of the world. So there are some ideas that it seems that we are almost want to grasp the most horrifying sometimes. The thing is, evil does exist to me, and cruelty, and people doing very dreadful things, and still amazed of our ability to be so cruel, human beings. The thing is how or where we find the source of evil. Guillermo del Toro, someone was telling me today that he said that there are two kind of movies about the devil from outside or the devil from inside. I'm afraid of the devil we are carrying inside.
I could hear chanting and squealing inside. It was a black mass. I knew they were doing stuff in the corners. Like flanking, torture. There was blood everywhere.
Fear must also have something nice or attractive, otherwise you wouldn't like to make scary movies. What is that?
I'm a masochist. I used to be very, very scared of anything when I was a boy, and totally irrational fear. And of course my parents didn't want to encourage that, so they wouldn't allow me to watch horror movies. But then my neighbors, who are U.S. citizens, they had this video player, and me and my brother started to watch at their home all these horror movies that my parents wouldn't allow us to watch in my house. And I think that must have been like some kind of shock treatment, because at the same time I was so terrified, but at the same time I just couldn't help watching them. And I think by getting to watch horror movies and then learning the tricks and starting to make movies, some of them horror movies, I think it's has helped me to get rid of many of my fears.